believe it or not, this is an original poster printed in 1967. It didn't always look this way. It looked like this. You're going to see how we fixed it today at Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix Studio. This poster, which features Bob Dylan, was in very poor condition. It was stained and yellow, and it had rips, and it needed to be linen-backed and restored. You're going to see that today. Take a look.
When I got this Bob Dylan, it came to me rolled in a tube, and it's got some pencil mark on it. It's browning. It's got a lot of rips in it.
There's this very long rip here, and another long rip here. And as you can see, the white part of the poster looks to be browning more at the top than at the bottom. There's also some pencil marks on here. I think they're pencil marks. They don't look right. They don't look like they belong to the poster. And here's some big rips in here. Here. I'm going to bleach this poster first.
Don't Look Back is a 1967 American documentary film directed by D.A. Pennebaker that covers Bob Dylan's 1965 concert tour in England. In 1998, the film was selected for preservation in the United States National Film Registry by the Library of Congress as being deemed culturally, historically, or aesthetically significant. In a 2014 Sight and Sound poll, film critics voted Don't Look Back the joint 9th best documentary film of all time. The opening scene of the film has Dylan displaying and discarding a series of cue cards bearing selected words and phrases from the lyrics to his song Subterranean Homesick Blues, including international misspellings and puns. This was the first single from his most recent album and a top 10 hit in the UK when he filmed it there. The film features Joan Baez, Donovan, Alan Price, who had just left the Animals. The film shows a young Dylan, confident, if not arrogant, confrontational and contrary, but also charismatic and charming. And as you can see, I've got the poster immersed in the bleach. It's going to sit in the bleach for a while to see if I can brighten up the paper and get rid of that stain.
I'm going to let Bob Dylan sit in the bleach for a few hours. Well, it is now evening. It's about 10:15 in the evening. I put this in the bath at about 4 o'clock, so I think I'm going to take it out now. I'm going to check to see how it looks.
Oh, it's definitely gotten brighter. I think all the staining is gone. Looks beautiful. Now I've got to take it out to dry. Yeah, it's definitely brightened up. I'm going to let this dry overnight. So, we'll see how this poster looks when it's dry in the morning. Well, now it's morning, and this poster has been drying all night. I think it's still a little bit damp, but we're going to linen back it, damp or not.
This is a stretched screen with cotton canvas stretched to it. And this is the acid-free paper that will get mounted to the screen. I do this by covering the paper with a lot of wheat paste lift the paper and attach it to the canvas. This paper is covered with wheat paste and is very wet. Then I put the screen up on the table, get it good and wet to help the paper absorb, and now I'm rolling out the paper to get rid of all the air pockets. And now the screen is ready for linen backing. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
Okay, I've prepared a screen and I'm going to put this Dylan poster down here, right next to the Milton Glaser Dylan poster. I'm putting the wheat paste directly onto the screen because the poster is too fragile to have the wheat paste added to it directly. Okay, I've placed the poster down onto the wheat paste and I am spraying the poster to help it expand. You see it getting darker as it absorbs the moisture. This paper is very thin. Using a sponge, I'm cleaning it, as you can plainly see. And there are trucks beeping outside. So Bob Dylan is linen backed and nice and flat, and it's going to dry for a few days before we touch it up and trim it down.
That about wraps it up for today's edition of Posterfix Studio. I look forward to seeing what posters you're going to send me. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, please email me, send me pictures, give me descriptions of their condition, and I will tell you how much it's going to cost to restore them. I'll offer suggestions on different approaches we can take. It's important that I know the sizes to give you the correct linen backing price. I look forward to seeing your posters, and I'll see you again on the next edition of Poster Fix Studio. Thank you.